What's going on, YouTube? John Conrad here from Drone One Media, and today I want to take a look at the new Final Cut Pro 10.4, and Apple just released this last week, and it's got a bunch of new features, including 360 video. You can edit and export 360 videos now, which is really cool. But today's video, I'm going to focus in on the updated color grading tools built right into Final Cut Pro. And I want to show you one in particular, and it's called the color wheel. Now, I have four different clips in my timeline. I just duplicated them. You can see these have been color graded, and these are raw, have not been color graded. So I want to show you kind of my process of how I got from here to here. So the new color wheels in Final Cut Pro are really neat, and they give you a little bit more control over the footage and how the color correction process goes, which I really like. So starting off with this first clip, you can see when you click the clip, you have the color correction, which we're all familiar with. This is the standard color correction tool built into Final Cut Pro. It was available in previous versions. You have color, saturation, and exposure controls, which is nice. It does a good job, but let me show you something really cool. So under the effects browser, if you go to color, you'll see this new option that says color wheels. So if you double click that, it will drop it right into this clip. And this is the new color wheels interface for Final Cut Pro 10.4. And you have the master, the shadows, the midtones, and the highlights. And basically what they did is they gave you an overview of not only your exposure, your saturation, and your color correction, all built right into these four wheels. So I've been playing around with this, and I think it's a really great improvement over previous versions, and I wanted to show you how I've used this on some of my clips from Best of 2017, which, by the way, if you haven't seen it, I'll have it linked in the description below. It's a compilation video of the best footage that I've shot over 2017. It's 4K. It's all shot with the Phantom 4 Pro. If you haven't checked it out, please do. I'll have it linked down below. I think you'll really, really enjoy it. So starting off with the highlights, so you can see my RGB parade over here on the left. If you grab the arrow on the right side of the wheel, you can see that adjusts the exposure for the highlights. So I want to probably leave it right about there, and that gives me a nice exposure in the highlights. Nothing is blown out. And next, I'll grab the brightness level or the exposure control of the shadows. And I like a little detail in my shadows. I mean, you can really bring it down here, but that really crushes the detail in the shadows. So I like to bring it up right about there. And next, the midtones, which you can see, you can really adjust it. I like it right about there. So you're really not losing any detail in the shadows or the midtones. Basically, when I color correct and color grade, I don't like to overdo it. I think a lot of people, when they color grade, they go really extreme and it just looks unprofessional. If you watch most films, most movies, the color grading is very subtle. There are exceptions. Transformers, for example, with their teal and orange was really extreme. But for the most part, most cinema and most film is very subtle and natural looking with their color grading and color correcting. So that's kind of the model that I like to follow. Next, now that we've done the exposure, this is the really cool part about the new color wheels in 10.4. You can adjust the saturation level for each, the shadows, the highlights, and the midtones. Whereas before, you could just adjust the saturation on the whole. So the really pretty sky up here on the top in the highlights, you know, I can pull that up and really bring the color out of the sky without adjusting the saturation in the midtones or the shadows, which is really, really neat. And the midtones, I'm going to do a little bit of color here, right about there. And the shadows, just see what that'll look like. It really makes it look really blue. So I'm just going to bring a little saturation out of the shadows. And that looks nice right there. And you can also adjust the temperature of the footage as well. So you can make it warmer or cooler. I like it right about right where it was at 5,000. And the highlights, bring that saturation level down a bit. Looks to be a little extreme there. And once you saturate the image, you want to go back into your exposure level or your brightness level. Sometimes when you add saturation, it can actually overexpose the image, which you can see here in the reds. It's brought it up and it's a little overexposed there. So I'm going to go back to the highlights, bring that down, bring those highlights down there. That way you have very minimal, it's a little overexposed right in there, but not too bad. And the rest of the clouds look good. And looks like the shadows are a little dark. I'm going to bring those up just a touch there. So that would be what I would use as my base grade. And then from there, I like to use a LUT, usually a film look or cinema look LUT. So I'm going to add a Color Finale Pro to use as my LUT tool. So I'm going to go ahead and open those controls. And I've done a couple videos on Color Finale in the past. I'll make sure I link those as well down below. It's a really great tool for color grading and color correcting. I like it a lot. With the new color wheels in 10.4, I think I will be using that more just because it gives you a little bit more control. And then I will be using Color Finale still to do my LUTs. And you can use, there are a bunch of different LUTs. I use the DLX LUTs, the DLX Cinema Look LUT I like a lot. And you can see when I apply it here, it's obviously really strong and overpowering. So you can dial the opacity of the LUT down. And I like it somewhere between about 15 to 25%. I think it looks good right about there. Okay, so that's what we've done so far. So let's take the effects off. So this was the raw file before we started adding the base grade or the LUT using Color Finale, and then that's after. So it gives it a really nice look. It's not too extreme. It's just kind of a nice balance of orange in the highlights and blue in the shadows, which is always very pleasing to look at. And so that's the first clip. So let's move on to the second clip. So this was a clip that I shot over Mono Lake in the Eastern Sierra region. And let's go ahead and add the color wheels. And starting with the highlights here, dial those down a bit, right about there. The shadows, pull down to right about there, and the midtones. The midtones I like to just kind of play with and then find the middle ground, you know, where it looks the best, right about there. And the saturation, turn up a little bit in the highlights. Definitely add some color into the water, which you can see it really is only changing the water. So add a little bit of color there. And midtones, again, the water and the tufas are changing. Add a little bit there. So I think that looks pretty good. So another nice little feature is you can actually pinpoint where the exposure levels are for each of the colors. And you can do this by dragging your mouse up and down. So from 0 to 100, you can see right where the top and the bottom exposure levels are. And so it's another nice little feature that Apple added in 10.4 on Final Cut Pro. So now that I have these done, I'm going to go ahead and add the LUT. So that's done using the Color Finale. And you can use multiple LUT tools. I just happen to use Color Finale, but there are lots of them out there. So I'm going to add the same Cinema Look LUT and dial the opacity down. About there, looks nice. All right, next up we have a shot that is a little bit more difficult in my opinion to color grade because you have really strong sun coming through. This was shot in the British Virgin Islands this spring. And so I'm going to go ahead and add the color wheels to start. So the highlights look, they look pretty good. You can always come back to them later, since they're the most difficult to get right. The shadows I'm going to bring down to about there. The midtones bring up just a little bit, so you get a little more detail in the hillside there. Next, I'm going to go ahead and saturate it right about there. So again, you can really make it look extreme, or you can dial it back. I like it somewhere about right there. And the midtones about right there. That looks pretty nice. And now the highlights, you can adjust. As you can see, the red is overexposed, so we definitely lost some detail here, which is sort of a limitation of the camera. On the Phantom 4 Pro, the dynamic range, while it is high, it's still hard to get proper exposure everywhere, especially when you're shooting into the sun. So sometimes you have to sacrifice a little detail where the sun might be. But overall, I think that looks pretty good right about there. And I'm going to go ahead and add the LUT. Finally, this clip was also shot in the British Virgin Islands. It's a nice midday clip, so I kind of wanted to get a variety of different colors and different times of the day for this tutorial. And so I'm going to go ahead and add the color wheels. Adjust the shadows here. Down to about there. Midtones maybe bring up just a little bit. All right. Highlights. Shadows. Midtones. So you can go really blue, but dial it back to about there. And these color wheels, you can adjust the color balance. You can really add a lot of different colors if you want. I prefer to shoot in decent alike, and you really don't have to adjust a whole lot there. But you can if you need to balance it out or match it with a handheld camera or something like that. That's what those center adjusters are for. You can adjust it in the highlights, the shadows, the midtones, or the master. And if you notice, I'm really not using the master, because with this amount of control, I prefer to spend a little bit more time and really dial in the color correction and the color grading using the shadows, the midtones, and the highlights rather than just adjusting the master. But again, it all comes down to how much time you want to spend color grading your footage. Add the LUT. And again, along those same lines, I'm just simply adding a cinema look LUT on top of this footage. Something that I prefer to do personally on my projects is I'll go in and adjust the HSL, which is the hue, the saturation, and the luminosity for each of the colors. You can use that in conjunction with the vector scope. You can maximize the dynamic range that way, which I like doing. I'm not doing it in this tutorial just because I've done it in previous tutorials that are linked in the description below. So make sure you check those out, and make sure you check out the best of 2017. These clips are pulled directly from that. It's a compilation, like I said, of the best drone footage that I've shot all year long across the Caribbean, the United States, and Canada. I think you'll really enjoy it. So make sure you check that out. And that has been a look at the color wheels and the new color grading and color correction tools that are built right into Final Cut 10.4. You don't need any additional software to do it. Just make sure if you have Final Cut Pro 10, you can upgrade to Final Cut Pro 10.4, which I am running here. And that's been a quick look. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave it a like, share it with a friend. Let me know in the comments if you want me to do more of these type of videos. And I want to say thank you so much for all the support. We're past 6,000 subscribers on Drone One Media, which is crazy. I had 300 at the beginning of the year. So thank you so much for all the support. Keep watching the videos, and I'll keep making them. This has been John Conrad for Drone One Media. Thank you so very much for watching, and we'll catch you in the next video.